Okay, when we want to go open up Google Photo, we go up here to the app launcher, the Google app launcher. When you click that, you find Photo and go ahead and click that. Now, once we're in Photo, now what we want to do is add some more photos to this. There's the easiest way to do that is open up your files and pick whatever ones you want out of here, and you can drag them over one at a time. Okay, or you can, as you saw before, we can drag an entire folder over. Now, when we drag an entire folder over, what we want to do is pull that over and let it go ahead and cycle through each one of those. Once it's loaded, you'll see that it's going to ask us whether we want to, we want to skip this because we're going to skip this. I'm going to show you the file. It's going to be a thumbnails.db, which is basically a file that is in that directory basically for the Windows operating system, and it's not needed. And Google Photo understands that. So whenever you see this thumbs.db, you can delete them. They don't mean anything to us. They only mean it to the Windows operating system. So after you've uploaded a folder, then you can give it a folder name or an album, calling it an album. Click on a new album, and then you can name that album right now. Which I have to go back and look at the name of it. There it is. So I could just slowly click on this twice, and that'll open up the ability to change the name. I can take that and copy it to my clipboard. Don't know how to do it this way. What I normally do is go in here and highlight it, and then I could right click and do a copy, and then come back over here and then click, and then right click and then do a paste. So I didn't have to touch my keyboard right there. Okay, let's do that, this whole operation again. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to take a whole folder, and we're going to take this Cameo 2008 right here, and we're going to just slide that over from our computer into the web browser, into the Google Photos, and then let go. And then it's going to start uploading all of those photos there. Okay, so if we look at this skipped file, we're going to see that it's the thumbs.db, which is only for the Windows operating system. So we'll skip that. Now that we have the 28 items that have been uploaded, do we want to add them to an album? We're going to create a new album, and I forgot the name already. So we'll go back over here as the Cameo 8. I could right click in here, rename. That will light that up. It will highlight that. That's unhighlighted. And I'm going to highlight it again. I'm going to grab it with a right click and copy it. And I'm going to go back over in here where I'm supposed to type in the title, and I'm going to right click it again, and I'm going to do a paste. Okay, so that we've named that album. So at this point we have the Cameo album, and we have the Appolite album, and then this album. Remember, I combined the two and we didn't get two separate albums. It's all combined into one, because we didn't do it one at a time. So just so you know, what we're going to do at this point is just delete this album, because I know that I have the Cameo and I have the Appolite in. So if I wanted to bring another one over, I would just come in here and say, let's take the Bounder 2005 and let's bring it over. And then we're going to just wait for it to upload, and most likely it's going to bring in that thumbs.db file, which is a Windows file, and it has no business in Google's Photos, and that's why they ask you to skip it. Okay, we're going to skip this file, and we're going to continue here. We're going to make making an album, create a new album, and then we're going to name that album. I believe it was Bounder 2000. To grab that name, I could right click, rename, right click, copy, right click over here in the web page, and paste. And we have it. Go back to our original albums, and we can see we have all of the albums. Now, let's suppose this album here, we don't like that picture. Let's suppose we want to have this picture at the top. I think if I take that picture, I think I can take that picture and grab it up over here. Maybe not. Let's just see. Can I do that? No, I can't. So if I go here and I right click it, if I just click it, now we come up with a lot of information and we can actually give more of a description here. But it tells you some information about the picture and I am looking for, here's some of the photographic, the shutter speeds, the f-stops, how that shot was taken and with what camera. So a lot of detailed information comes from here, which is basically this little info button right here, okay? But when it comes to setting it up in the album's first page, use as album cover. There it is. So we want to use it as the album cover. And now when we go back, remove item from album. Items removed from an album remain part of the... Okay, so if we tell it to remove it, now we go back. And let's see, did it bring it up to the cover of the album like we asked it to do? It didn't look like it did it, so let's try it again. And I think we removed it from the album. We did. There's another picture here. So let's go back. While I made this mistake, I'm going to go back. I'm going to go to all the pictures. And now we're going to hunt that one down, which was the Bounder Motorhome front view picture. And it is, it was this one. Remember, that's the one that's there. So we're going to take that one. And now we're going to have to add it to an album. And it wants to know which album. There we go. Okay, add it to the album. Let's view the album now. And when we view the album, we see that it is added where? Not there. One photo. That's interesting. I see that one, but I thought we had two. Okay, let's try it again. We go into that. No, we have to go into all pictures, and then, even if it was this one, and we say add to album, add it to the Bounder album, which has 34 elements. So let's see if it has 35 elements now. Just don't like it right there. It seems like it should be that first picture. Or I could see it being the last picture, but it threw it right in the middle. It threw it right in here. So that's what happened. So now that we have that, if we want to say make this one the album cover, use as album cover. Changing the album cover changed. And let's see what we have. Let's go back to albums, and there we are. So we can see that's how you change the album cover. Okay, that's another little lesson on Google Photos.